name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. So as to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. You have come to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call all sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy. The Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, grant us so to celebrate the mysteries of the Lord's Passion, that we may merit to receive your pardon through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Hear me, O islands, listen, O distant peoples. The Lord called me from earth, from my mother's womb. He gave me my name. He made of me a sharp-edged sword and concealed me in the shadow of his arm. He made me a polished arrow. In his quiver he hid me. You are my servant, he said to me, Israel, through whom I show my glory. Though I thought I had toiled in vain, and for nothing uselessly spent my strength, yet my reward is with the Lord, my recompense is with my God. For now the Lord has spoken, who formed me as his servant from the womb, that Jacob may be brought back to him, and Israel gathered to him, and I am made glorious in the sight of the Lord, and my God is now my strength. It is too little, he says, for you to be my servant, to raise up the tribes of Jacob, and restore the survivors of Israel. I will make you a light to all nations, that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord. I will sing of your salvation. I will sing of your salvation. In you, O Lord, I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your justice, rescue me and deliver me. Incline your ear to me and save me. I will sing of your salvation. Be my rock of refuge, a stronghold to give me safety. For you are my rock and my fortress. O my God, rescue me from the hand of the wicked. I will sing of your salvation. For you are my hope, O Lord, my trust. O God, from my youth, on you I depend from birth. From my mother's womb, you are my strength. I will sing of your salvation. My mouth shall declare your justice, day by day your salvation. O God, you have taught me from my youth. Until the present, I proclaim your wondrous deeds. I will sing of your salvation. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Reclining at table with his disciples, Jesus was deeply troubled and testified, Amen, amen, I say to you, one of you will betray me. The disciples looked at one another at a loss as to whom he meant. One of his disciples, the one whom Jesus loved, was reclining at Jesus' side. So Simon Peter nodded to him to find out what he meant. He leaned back against Jesus' chest and said to him, Master, who is it? Jesus answered, It is the one to whom I hand the morsel after I had dipped it. So he dipped the morsel and took it and handed it to Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot. After Judas took the morsel, Satan entered him. So Jesus said to him, What you are going to do, do quickly. Now none of those reclining at table realized why he said this to them. But what we mean for the feast, or to give something to the poor. So Judas took the morsel and left at once, and it was night. When he had left, Jesus said, Now is the Son of Man glorified, and God is glorified in him. If God is glorified in him, God will also glorify him himself, and he will glorify him at once. My children, I will be with you only a little while longer. You will look for me, and as I told the Jews, where I go, you cannot come. So now I say it to you. Simon Peter said to him, Master, where are you going? Jesus answered him, Where I am going, you cannot follow me now, though you will follow later. Peter said to him, Master, why can I not follow you now? I will lay down my life for you. Jesus answered, Will you lay down your life for me? Amen, amen, I say to you, the cock will not crow before you deny me three times. The Gospel of the Lord. Today's Gospel is a very interesting Gospel because it is about betrayal, but also it's also about discipleship. Judas Iscariot chooses to betray Christ, and allegorically speaking, Judas Iscariot represents this relationship that God and Israel always had together. Israel would always lose sight of what that covenant is. Many times Israel would fall and be attracted to the temptations of Babylonia, Assyria, and the Greeks. Now here in this story, Judas Iscariot represents that macrocosm, this sort of microcosm of a drama between Judas, Jesus Christ, and the disciples. And yet, through this story of betrayal, there is still hope. Now, we again see Peter, who says that he'll follow Christ till whatever end, and Jesus says that you're going to betray me, and you'll know this will happen when the cock crows three times. And yet, there's still hope. The hope is that we're simply not ready to follow Christ into the gates of heaven. We're not ready yet. It doesn't mean that we'll never be ready. It just means that we're not ready yet. We are going through this life journey of learning, how to be the disciple of Christ, learning how to follow Christ. But that takes a lot of work. That takes a lot of discipleship. That takes a lot of training. And when we are ready, Christ welcomes us with full arms, open to embrace us. Now, I know that I am a Catholic priest in the Catholic Church and a friar in the Order of St. Augustine, but I am not ready yet either. I myself am still going through this training, this discipleship. The only difference is that I can speak on this ampo and read the Gospel and read to you, but we are all in this together. We are all being trained together. We are all journeying together. We are all called to follow Christ to the end, despite our failures, despite the fact that we might deny Christ three times. Now, that being said, we do our best to encourage each other because we know it's hard. We know it's not easy. We know the stakes that are around us. We know the risks that there are around us, the temptations that are around us. It's not an easy life of being a virtuous Christian. And yet, God calls us. God calls us in this life of difficulty. As we struggle through making sense of this reality of the pandemic, how do we make sense of it? How do we live our lives as Christians? Well, we can start by being attentive to what's happening outside. There's been an increase of vandalism in people's stores, hoarding. A lot of this stuff we can also talk about in terms of virtue, that we have practices of virtue like prudence, temperance, being aware of ourselves, that we're here to help each other and not become more selfish. Christ is asking us this one difficult task. It's to be selfless. So how do we be selfless in this time of the pandemic? How do we be virtuous Christians in this time of the pandemic? And I know it's hard, but that's why God calls us, because it's hard. So let us now offer our prayers to our God, trusting in the God who walks with us always. We bring our needs to our Lord and Savior. For our members of the church, may Christ strengthen us as we share the good news of the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord. For leaders and those who carry responsibility for the welfare of others, may Jesus guide them the ways of servant leadership. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who are struggling or suffering, may God's love and presence with them bring consolation and comfort. Let us pray to the Lord. For all those gathered here, may God open our hearts more fully and increase our faith in Him. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who have died, may they rest in the loving presence of God. Let us pray to the Lord. For any special intentions we may have, let us pray in the silence of our hearts. Today we pray especially for Margaret Ann, Pete Rios, Agnes, and also prayers to Jane Kim Estantino. God of love and tenderness, we know that you carry us in our struggles. Hear our prayers today, and give us all we need to do your will. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, the fruit of the earth and the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, the fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become our spiritual fruit. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, lift your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the glory of all the gospel of the church. Look favorably, O Lord, we pray, on these offerings of your family, and to those who make partakers of these sacred gifts, grant a share in their fullness, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father. For the days of His saving passion and glorious resurrection are approaching, by which the pride of the ancient foe is vanquished, and the mystery of our redemption in Christ is celebrated. Through Him the Most of Angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, to spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, all the clergy, and all those who serve. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We now pray the words that Christ has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we wait the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace, Lord, be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul. Let us pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, Lord, that by this same sacrament with which you have fed us in the present age, you may make us partakers of life eternal, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.